I'm Andrew Evans.
And I'm Steve Palfreman.
We're two of the leaders of Christchurch Liverpool that on Sundays meets here at Archbishop Brand School. If you're watching this DVD, it's probably because you've been along to our church, or are considering coming along, or maybe you just want to know a little bit more about what kind of church we are and what kind of values we have. And this short DVD is designed to show you some of the things that our church does, and also explain to you some of what we're about and our values.
Our ultimate goal at Christchurch Liverpool is to bring glory to God. This is the most important thing we believe as a church. We believe it because the Bible tells us that as far as God is concerned, the most important thing that can happen in the universe is that people will recognise God for who He is and worship and honour Him in their lives. We think that the whole point of the universe, the reason it was made, is to demonstrate just what a great God God is. So we try and play our small parts in the universe by telling people how great God is, and we hope trying to live lives that point people to God who made everything.
Now obviously, as one local church, we can't be very effective in telling the whole world about God. So our vision is particularly to bring glory to God amongst people who live, work or study in Liverpool city centre. We do believe that there's a good news, a message in Christianity that the whole world needs to hear. But the main focus of our church is to work with and amongst people who are in Liverpool city centre. Lots of churches work more or less with people who live in a particular place. But our church community is a bit different. It's not just a geographical community of where people live. We also want to engage with people who work or study in the city centre, but who may live somewhere else, often many miles away, maybe even in another town or another city. The reason we do that is because we want to reflect the fact that for many people in our church, their primary community, the people they spend most time with, isn't their next door neighbours or even the people on their street. It's the colleagues in their office or their school or their hospital. It's the people who they meet in their lecture theatre on their university course. It's their friends who they gather with to do social activities, or maybe even their family. And our vision as a church is to help people to be comfortable in introducing all of those folk that they meet to other Christians through the church family, and most of all to Jesus Christ as they come and hear about Him from His Word, the Bible.
In order to go about this task of bringing glory to God in the place that He's put us, you'll see that there are seven key things that we're trying to do as a church. And the rest of this DVD will take you through them. There's obviously some overlap between them, but hopefully they'll give you an idea and a flavour of what we're doing as a church. The first of our key aims is evangelism, by which we mean introducing people to the message about Jesus Christ and helping them to understand it and giving them opportunity to ask their questions so that we know they're really clear about what Jesus demands of them. As a church, we believe it's essential for us to be really clear what the message is that God has given in the Bible for the whole world to hear. The gospel, or good news, of the Bible is really about how God can be holy and merciful at the same time. This is good news because as rebels who don't acknowledge God for who He is, we deserve the judgment or punishment of God. Yet in the mercy of God, we find that because Jesus died, we can receive forgiveness instead of judgment. When we become Christians, an exchange takes place. Our rebellious nature is placed on Jesus, who takes the punishment it deserves at the cross. And His perfect nature, His record of perfect obedience, is given to us freely. And at Christchurch, we think that that is good news. In fact, we think it's the best and most important news in all the world. So we spend a lot of our time as a church thinking of creative ways to bring that good news to all sorts of people who haven't heard it or who have heard it but don't yet believe it. Just across the border and into the city, you and I can both get jobs and finally see what it means to be living.
It's amazing how many people spend an enormous amount of time and energy thinking about keeping fit, training, doing exercise, and generally improving themselves in all sorts of different ways. As a church, we're absolutely convinced that people need to do that in their Christian lives as well. So one of the things that we're about as a church is training, I guess you could call that discipleship, encouraging people to think about their Christian lives in all sorts of different aspects. And we think that that happens when the Bible is taught and explained to people so that we can understand God's revelation of himself that we find there. All of these different kinds of training are designed to get us fit for the Christian life, to help people to think about how they can live their whole lives as disciples of Jesus, following him in every way.
Most people, when they think about church, think about a building, probably an old building, something like this. In fact, in Liverpool, people still refer to this as a church, even though it has no roof. When the Bible talks about church, it talks about a group of people together, about Christians who are united together because they believe in Jesus. It talks about church being like a family, a group of people who love each other and care for each other. And that's our third principle as a church family. We want to be a family who care for one another, look out for each other, and serve each other. Sometimes that's not very easy, because we're not always that easy to get on with. But we believe it's really important to commit ourselves to doing that, to forgiving one another, to looking out and caring for each other, however hard that might be, because that's what we believe the Bible says church really is.
Some people in our church, like me, get to spend their time playing around making DVDs like this one and studying the Bible sometimes as well. There's a view around in some Christian circles that really work is just there to feed your face, to provide for your family, to enable you to earn money to give to church and maybe to give you some opportunities to talk about Jesus. But as a church, we're convinced that work is much more than that. And we want to encourage everybody who comes to our church to think about their work in a Christian way. We don't subscribe to the idea it's a hierarchy of more important spiritual tasks and less important secular tasks. Actually, what we want to do is to encourage everyone in our church to work out, how am I going to live for the glory of Jesus in the particular workplace that I'm in? How am I going to be the best Christian doctor, Christian accountant, Christian office worker, Christian teacher, or whatever that I possibly can be?